you know, come 2020, you know, when I am going for re-election, we're changing the name of Crystal Lake to Birdtown Lake. Birdtown is, you know, great place. I wanna spread the Birdtown message, you know. I want people to flock to Birdtown, you know.
What a load of crap. Well, at least I got my good shot in. Spellman! Sorry, Selman. I need you in here right now. Come on in.
Big Dog Redog, you called?
We need to have a meeting. Tonight.
Tonight?
Tonight. I want you to call Fat back and we're gonna have a meeting about the future of Robbinsdale. I just watched those young punks make fun of me in my own town. We need to have a meeting about the future of Birddale. We need to have it tonight. We need to talk about the future of Birddale. We need to make Birddale great again. Salmon, where is this fat backer?
Well, that's not how you pronounce my name, and his name is Pat last time I checked.
Whatever.
And he was at a business meeting. You should be here any second.
I'm so sick of this monkey business between everybody. Why can't anybody just be on time like I'm always on time? With the Hy-vee ribbon cutting, I was on time. Come in.
Sorry, I got stuck in line to be in my business meeting.
Where were you? We've been sitting here for an hour trying to think of new places to put Hy-vee 2.0. There's a lot of historic buildings in this town that need to be demolished and more Hy-vees that need to go up. And what's with all the pizza boxes? Are you gonna eat those all yourself? Fat backin'?
The name's Pat!
Why are these so light?
There was a lot of traffic, okay? I got hungry, pizza, traffic, you know? Things happen.
Are these all empty?
Oh, there might be some crust left in there if you guys really want some. Wow, I supply you pizza crust and you don't even say thank you.
Thank you, I guess, but you're still late.
I'm sorry, Big Dog. Look, I just can't help myself when Pig ate my pizza is 10 for 10. It's a great deal, okay? Next time, maybe I'll save you leftovers. I promise.
Now don't overdo it, Pat. We still need to have some praise for Hy-vee out there, you know.
Sorry about that, Big Dog. You're right, I overdid it. All the praise should go to Hy-vee and Hy-vee only.
Alright. Let's get down to business. Number one, we need to get more people into Hy-vee.
How are we gonna get people into Hy-vee?
It's simple, really. All we have to do is tear down every building that stands in Hy-vee's way. And I mean any building. Even if it comes to travail, we'll tear travail down. That's how serious I am about getting everybody into Hy-vee. Everybody must love Hy-vee.
The greatest thing in the world, Hy-vee.
That's the attitude I want to see from everybody.
What about the Terrace Theater?
Fat?
And there is Pat.
You know when you talk about that blighted heap of bricks, you're supposed to call it the pre-Hy-vee zone. You know, I did not. What are you doing?
I'm taking a picture to document this.
We're not supposed to take pictures. This is supposed to be incognito. You know what would happen if they found out we broke the Minnesota open meeting law?
What?
Oh, bad things could happen, that's what. I couldn't become mayor and you couldn't have such a mediocre job in the city of Robbinsdale. You could be working for some crystal. Working at Cub Foods.
Cub Foods.
Yes, Cub Foods. So keep it on the down low.
Yeah, you don't want to work at Cub Foods. I worked there once. Nothing at all like Hy-vee. Hy-vee is great. It's wonderful. It's amazing.
But we had these meetings during the Terrace Theater fight.
That was a different story. We needed that Hy-vee, you know, and we needed those meetings to help brainwash. I mean, persuade. I mean, inform you that we really needed it and why we really needed it. No more monkey business. We need to get to the next topic. The water tower in downtown. It's becoming iconic, and worst of all, it's historic. So we need to take it down as soon as we can.
Now moving on to our next topic. Our citizens are having way too much contact with the outside world. My mom was on Facebook yesterday and they were talking about how great Golden Valley was. Do you know what that's gonna do to our citizens? Thinking that our town can be almost as perfect as Golden Valley? They're gonna get the wrong idea, then they're gonna wanna leave. So I am initiating the Birdtown Privacy Act. It's a two-pronged approach. Number one, internet censorship for anybody outside the Robbinsdale area. Number two, we're gonna build a big wall around Robbinsdale to prevent any influence coming in from any other city. It's gonna be big, it's gonna be wonderful. And that stupid orange president took the words right out of my mouth. I've been planning this for years and years. You know, guys, I got some pretty big plans for Birddale. You guys want to see my plans?
Yeah, sure.
To the Robbie Cave. Well, thank you for joining me at my lair, the Robin Cave.
Wait, how did we get here?
Some questions are best left unanswered, friend. How did you get McDonald's?
We literally one?
We teleported here. How did you? What are you guys doing? Come on in!
What are you jacking for?
Well, you know, every lab has to have precautions, you know, chemicals, good stuff like that, everything like that.
Where's your food?
Here, I got some plant food for you. It'll help you grow big and strong. My dad used to give me that. Taking off my kilt here.
I'm gonna grow bigger.
I hope you guys don't mind. I took my kilt off. Ready? Yeah, right, to the message board. This, friends, this is how we're gonna take over Birddale and become Murphydale. We begin at my house.
Whoa, what kind of food you got over at your house?
We have all kinds of food. With the sun shining down upon us, we proceed to phase one, where we go to Hy-vee.
Okay, what kind of food do they got?
They got good food, all kinds of food.
I shop there every day.
It's a good place. Phase two has us going to Wicked Wart.
Why so much beer and no food?
Why do you ask stupid questions? Good. Phase three is we finally get all of our bird brain buddies together, and we head straight to Travail and eat.
What kind of food does Travail have?
Then we proceed to the main town with rainbows.
Oh, so Irish food.
It's so offensive.
Oh, so you're Irish? Oh, that explains all the beer and your plan and all the bars in town.
I don't even find that funny.
Is there any pots of gold there too?
That's equally as offensive. Anyways, what did you guys think about the diagram?
Oh, it's great.
Thank
Wonderful.
You.
You draw it with crayons?
There's a lot of beer and not a lot of food, but it's okay. I like it.
I drew it myself. Thank you for interrupting me 8 times, but I drew it myself. Stole my daughter's crayons, you know, good stuff. Anyways, on to some now more fun stuff, my woodworking station. And now, friends, this is the final phase. Hold this for me.
Oh.
This is the rebuild process. We'll do this, you know, we'll find all the materials in the woods, you know, because that's where you find wood. Yeah, it's really easy to find. If you just go out in the woods and you can find it. Now, let us begin the rebuild process by me showing you how fast I can craft something. Ready, set, go! See, the trick is you put your hand as close to the saw blade as you can. And if you cut yourself, it's no big deal.
That doesn't look like you're a black duck.
It's a bird. And no, this is art.
This looks like my mom's world famous pork chop.
How do you get food out of this?
I don't know. It's like a pork chop. What can I say?
Now that this is done, gentlemen, I have one last thing to discuss with you. And now, gentlemen, that this is all complete, I want to first thank you for coming out. It's very nice to have everybody. I'm going to have to kill you.
Whoa.
What's going on here?
Got you guys. Toy gun. You should have seen the looks on your face. Alright. Let's go hit up Hy-vee. I totally go in there. I'm a cool kid. Come on.
Regan is a fixer.
Come on in!
Finding items in disarray.
What are you guys doing? Come on in!
The Bat Cave. Or the Robin Cave, I should say.
Regan is a big...
Well, thank you for joining me at my lair, the Robin Cave.
Wait, how did we get here?
What's cool about woodworking, it's easy to work with. Inexpensive materials, you can find it, you know, in the woods. This is kind of what we use to drill the holes.
He made this cribbage board for his family to enjoy.
We'll do this, you know, we'll find all the materials in the woods, you know, because that's where we got wood. Yeah, it's really easy to find. You just go out in the woods and you can find it.
Get locked in my lab here, get stuff done, and I will emerge like a butterfly eventually with something hopefully beautiful.
So I wanna spread the Birdtown message, you know. I want people to flock to Birdtown, you know.